In comedy, as you know, and it's the way I've lived for a long time, you often do sketches or you say things that when they're seen in their comedic context, they're funny. But if you just read it, you know,
hence the dehumorizer.
If you and what happened, and you talk about it really well in your campaign, is that they would take jokes that you had made in articles that you had written. I think you wrote an article once for Playboy magazine. You just little things that you had done. The other campaign would take it and write it as if you really believed that thing when it was clearly a joke. Do you know what I mean?
And well, yes. I in that article, I wrote a very conservative joke about. This was the millennial issue of Playboy, January 2000, and William F. Buckley wrote in it, and Isaac Asimov, the science fiction writer, and then they had me.
Right.
And so I thought I'd write something funny about, you know, the hip things, because Playboy would do what the new hi-fi that a hip man should have. And so I thought, okay, virtual sex. I'll talk about the internet and how great it is. And I had a joke which said that my son did a great sixth grade report last year. The internet is a great learning tool. He did a great sixth grade report last year on bestiality. And and the kids in the class just loved it because he downloaded a lot of great visual aids. And the kids loved it. And, you know, at that age, they're just sponges. So now, to me, that's a joke. That's basically saying parents monitor what your kids are doing on the internet, which is a conservative idea. But they used it. They did an ad which is Alf Franken. So depraved that he wrote jokes about bestiality. And it came from like infinity. Like in your living room through your eyeballs and rattled back your skull.
You have to do bestiality turning to that camera again.
Which one?
It's three. It's you gotta do
bestiality.
The word.
And my mother-in-law cried when she saw the ad.
Oh, yeah.
Because she knew that wasn't me.
Yeah.
And, or, you know, she knew.
Right.
So, stuff was taken out of context. And, you know, I just, that's why when I got to the Senate, I just said, I can't be funny. I won re-election by a pretty comfortable margin. So now I've written the book, and I'm hopefully I'm still a workhorse, and I'm still gonna.
Yeah.
Still, it's an honor to be there and work hard for the people of Minnesota, and that's what I'm doing. But I can be a workhorse with a sense of humor.
With a sense of humor, and I do think it's I do think that we've had in America some very funny statesmen over the years, and it would be nice if people were allowed to be funny in political life.
Well, I have some very funny colleagues who are funny in the way you're allowed to be funny.
Yeah.
It's just that we come from a whole different
school. Well, we're sick people, yeah.
Yes. Wait a minute, no.
Well, you heard it here, he's a sick man.